Hey, what's up there, YouTube? This is Use. So, I came back. I went to work today. I was supposed to be on Friday because my bosses weren't there, so other people were giving me a chance to do some things I wouldn't normally do. And I was on Friday for about 2 minutes. And I was really pissed because I love doing fire. I'm a little slow because of my disability, but it doesn't stop me from working as hard as I can and doing it, what to do, And so the manager came up to me, one of the managers, and he said, you can be on the toast here because I can't. I can't be back here helping you out all the time and all that, so I'm going to have you do lobby and be on toaster and what you usually do. I'm like, okay, we can do that. I guess we can do that. No, he wasn't trying to be a jackass or anything. He wasn't being a jackass. But, he just didn't give me a chance to, be on there for very long. It kind of pissed me off for the rest of the day. And so I went out and did lobby and everything, and everything was going good. Since I've been working there at Arby's, I have been doing lobby cleaning and stuff like that. And while I'm cleaning, customers will be sitting at the table doing their thing, and they'll just look at me for a second and go, and they'll just stare at me because of my hands. I can't use my hand very well, so it looks a little weird. So it kind of pisses me off. It pisses me off a lot. So now I'm more aware of my hand, and I try hiding it more so people don't look at it. And I've been like that now since summer, and it's just, I don't know what it is about it, but I'm more aware of it, and I don't know. It pisses me off that people do that, because I never had a problem before that. Nobody looked at me. Nobody. Everybody looked at me and started staring at me until I started working at Arby's. It's just weird. I'm just so, man, it really makes me mad. But anyway, it's just, I don't like it at all. But anyway, what else have I been doing? Oh yeah. So I wanted to talk to you today about my whole reason I'm here was today was to talk about my life up till now. For some of you guys have already heard this. For new subscribers and new viewers, I'll get you guys caught up with who I am. So I was born and raised in Phoenix, Arizona. I live in a suburb of Phoenix, and that town was called Avondale. For the first 10 years of my life, I lived back and forth between California and Arizona, or vice versa, because I was born and raised in Arizona, so it would be, I moved in between Arizona and California 2 or 3 times. The reason being was because my dad is a nuclear engineer, and he had to be in 2 places at once, so we always moved back and forth. I've lived in California for a period of 2 to 3 years. I've lived in Arizona for a period of 5 to 6 years at a time. So between that 10 period of time, those first 10 years of my life, I was doing that. But since then, when I was about 10, when I was in 4th grade, and I think I was 10, I moved to Minnesota. My parents divorced and did a picture. I moved up to Minnesota where my mother's family is. And so we moved up here. My mom, 2 or 3 years after we moved here, she met somebody. She got remarried. Things are great now. My stepdad, he's a good person, and just, you know, he pisses me off, just like all step parents do at some point. My dad got remarried to a great person as well. She has two kids, a son and a great people, like them a lot, respect them a lot. And then my stepdad, the person my mom got married to, he has two kids as well, Tyler and Jennifer. Tyler's awesome. He's the person I'm living with, actually. He's one of my roommates. He's awesome. And Jennifer is a good person too. He makes bad decisions sometimes, but I don't know. It's life. But yeah, they're both happily married. Thanks for voting for them. I go down to Arizona about every summer. Try to. I've been going there every summer since I was about 10, even when I moved away. So it's all good. It's all good. But yeah, my dad got remarried in London. My stepmom and her kids were living in London for a while. Their mother grew up in Africa, and unfortunately, my stepmom's husband, before she got married to my dad, he died, and they just met in London one time. I don't remember exactly how it happened. It was over a phone call or something like that, and they met in London. My dad went to London to see her and meet her, and they got married there. And I went there for the wedding when I was 10, 11 again. It was a great time. London is one of my favorite places to visit. I haven't been there since, but I really would like to go back. Really would like to go back. But yeah, right now I've lived in Minnesota. I've lived in three different towns: Stuartville, Chatfield, well, country of Chatfield, and I'm living in Rochester. So I've had my share of road trips and moving around and stuff like that. I mean, I've traveled to so many places in my life. I mean, I've been to New York, I've been to Detroit, I've been to, oh man, I've been to Mexico, I've been everywhere else. So it's a good time, Denver, stuff like that. So I've had my fair share of traveling, and it's nice. I like traveling. Knoxville. Just a few places I've been. But yeah. Work really bothered me the way they're, I don't know, people were staring at me and you know, it's awesome that, you know, my boss has so much confidence in me that he has to, you know, take me off fryer. Because he thinks I might be too slow. Way to boost that guy's confidence, man. Way to go. It pisses me off. It really does. It really does. But what are you gonna do, right? But anyway, this has just been a quick update. Well, not really. It's going on 9 minutes here, so this is just a regular blog here. We got a blog going here. But anyways, everybody. We will catch up with you guys soon, and hopefully I'll be getting more videos out here. You know, this is my second one since 2 weeks I've put up. So hopefully I get some more videos out there and things start going well. Till then, everybody, we'll talk to you later. Peace out.